Do you have a mountain of photos that you don't know what to do with? Well, you're in luck. We're going to talk to you about how to downsize and organize that photo collection with family history in mind. Howdy, I'm Devin Noel Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor stories along the way. And yes, organization fits into this because it's about climbing that tree and organizing and writing the stories behind all of those photos. But a viewer recently asked me this. I have 11 bins full of photo albums and loose photos, and I don't even know where to begin to get this mess organized. Well, let's talk about some of the things that I've learned about organization while downsizing myself and my mother and lots of other friends. The first step is to breathe. Okay, do it with me. Okay, now that breathing is out of the way, we're going to set aside some time to begin the process of digitizing the photos. But you're thinking, that's a lot of photos. Well, you're right. And not every photo in that collection deserves to be digitized or kept. So before you digitize, you need to organize. Organize to digitize. And organize also means getting rid of clutter. The first thing you need to do is to start sorting your photos and photo albums into categories. So as you're sorting these photo albums, you're looking at them and say, oh, this is my comforts from Canada. These are my Townsends from Ohio. These are my mom as a teenager. Start sorting them by surnames, location, something that makes sense to you, because the next step is to downsize. I know. People get so mad at me when I say downsize your photo collection. What does that mean? Well, let's say we'll take the comforts from Canada. It's entirely possible that those comforts from Canada are not your primary lines that you want to research. You want to spend more time on your Townsends. You want to spend more time on your mom's collection and your own personal history. So one way you can downsize those photos is to find other family members who will take good care of those photos and give them your collection to them. Or you can look for genealogical societies, historical organizations from the area your ancestors were from and consider making a donation to them. The other thing that's part of downsizing is tossing out some photos. I know. I get so many people so mad at me. But yes, you need to learn how to downsize your photo collection. That means getting rid of all of the duplicates. We have lots of duplicates of the same image in our collections, and we need to get rid of them. We also need to get rid of the blurry photos where you just can't tell what that was. But chances are you're never going to use those blurry pictures, so get rid of them. So get rid of blurry, get rid of duplicates, get rid of photos that you know you and nobody else is going to take time to restore because they're so poorly damaged. If the photos have mold on them, get rid of them. Downsize to photos that people are not likely want to see in the future. Then you can go to the next step. Now in this step, we're going to do fine sorting. And in fine sorting, this is when I like to organize my photos in chronological order. Now, before you start messing up the organizational system of your photographs, follow the advice from my friend, Melissa Barker, the archive lady. Take a picture of the collection, the organized one, the photo albums, not the loose ones, and take a picture of how the images were arranged in the photo album, because that could tell you a story. And then if your photos are in photo albums that are not high quality archival albums, gently remove them and start putting them in chronological order. because I have a blog post over on my blog that talks about how I solved a mystery because I put those photos in chronological order. Additionally, when you go to the next stage, which is digitize, you want these images in chronological order because the scanning improves when you have similarly colorized photos together. You don't have a sepia with a 1980s vibrant neon color image together running through a scanner. So organize them chronologically to improve the storytelling, but also the digitization. The other reason why you want to do this fine sort is organize is you don't want to create a big old digital mess. So get things organized physically so that when you do digitize your photos, they are organized as well. So then you need to start turning your attention to digitizing your collection. So when you digitize your collection, you can outsource it. Yeah, there are a number of companies that can help you digitize not only those photo albums and those loose photos, but they can also handle your slides and your negatives as well as other media, which we're not talking about today. But if you are seriously overwhelmed and you're technologically challenged with scanning photos, then cut yourself some slack. Ask for birthday gifts. Hey, I want this stuff digitized. Somebody buy me the birthday gift or anniversary gift or some holiday gift or just a gift because we survived some crisis recently or just because. Treat yourself to outsourcing it. You'll find a link to these companies in the description box. Now, if outsourcing is not in your budget, you can use flatbed scanners. Now, I have used my flatbed on my all-in-one printer combination. There is some debate whether it's good enough, but y'all, if you're going to scan something, use what you have, and you will be surprised how quickly you can get the job done and the quality that's going to be available to you. I just would avoid using a wand scanner because it doesn't do that good of a job. There are some other scanners you might want to check out. There is the FlipPal mobile scanner. There will be a link to that in the box. And the FlipPal mobile scanner allows you to hold this portable scanner, it's small, over your images and scan things in that way. Another option is to get the Joy Flips app, and you can use that, and the joy of flipping through your photo album as you're holding your tablet or phone over, and then it will scan the pages and then cut them up as well. So those are a lot of options for scanning and digitizing that photo bin collection. Then what? What are you gonna do? The next thing you want to do with all of those photos is share them. After you've digitized them, maybe you then want to take those photos and donate them to an archive library, or you want to donate them to other family members so that you have the digital copies and someone else can hold on to the physical copies. Something you should be thinking about as you're downsizing for the future, what are you going to do with this plan? But now that you have the digital images, you need to do something with them so they don't just stay in a box somewhere forever or on a hard drive. So I highly recommend you consider telling stories with your photos. One format is to do scrapbooking. You can check out the description box for links on how to create scrapbooks using Photoshop Elements, Shutterfly, or Mixbooks here on this channel. You can also share your images in online trees. FamilySearch has a great resource to help you share your images with your family member, especially for the deceased persons in your family. And I am an advocate of writing family stories. You can write short stories, children's books. There's a number of different formats you can choose. Check the description box for a link to a video on which format to use. But notice you can put pictures in all of these book formats to help tell your story. Taking care of your photos is probably the most important genealogical task that you can do right now to preserve your family history. If you need more tips and tricks on how to organize anything in your collection, check out this playlist right here.